Hey guys, have you ever taken any drone footage? Experienced creators can swing a drone to record the video. After post-production, the result can look epic. However, the safety of the drone might be more important for beginners. So most of the drone videos taken by beginners look static. That's why we bring you this tutorial. We are going to share with you how to turn boring static drone video into something dope like this. Hope our video can give you some inspiration. Now, let's dive in. Before getting started, be sure to download VideoProc Vlogger from the comment section. Launch VideoProc Vlogger. Start a new project. Let's firstly drag two drone clips onto the program. Add them to the video track by turn. Now, we check out the sample video. The dope look is actually created by the motion tool, which is for creating dynamic changes in our video. We click on motion. In our case, we just need to change the rotation angles. So let's click on add a keyframe to apply the edits manually. After creating the first keyframe, we need to take some steps to avoid the black bars after rotation. Let's firstly find rotation. Set the desired rotation angle. And then we resize the selection box. After that, we change the rotation angle to 0. That's how we create and set the first keyframe. Drag the playhead backward. Hit add keyframe. You'll notice we've created a new keyframe that shows the same range of the footage as the first keyframe. Now let's adjust the rotation angle to 10 degrees. That can bring some dynamic changes to the video. Next, we drag the playhead backward and add a new keyframe. Restore the rotation angle to 0. Take a look. You'll notice it doesn't look smooth. That's because the changes between three keyframes happen at a constant speed. We can adjust the speed mode over here to make the changes look more smooth and natural. After that, we've made clip 1 rotate from 0 degree to 10 and then back to 0. Now we just need to add a new keyframe. And make rotation goes in the opposite direction than the rotation of the previous frame. Adjust the speed mode. Add a new keyframe and restore the rotation angle to 0. Adjust the speed mode. And to seamlessly combine this clip and the next one, we need to add a new keyframe and rotate it. And then we add another keyframe at the last frame. Resize and reposition the selection box. That can build a zoom-in effect. After we add all these keyframes, let's preview the video. Great work. Hit apply to get back to the main interface. Now, let's add the second clip. Just like what we already did, we click on motion. To better match the clip 2 with the zoom in effect at the end of the clip 1, we can zoom out the beginning of this clip. Let's click on add a keyframe to add a keyframe at the first frame. scale down the selection box and change its position to make it cover only a few elements. Then drag the playhead to the proper position and add a keyframe. Changing the rotation angle to 10. Scale up the selection box and reposition it to make it cover more elements. After that, we change the speed mode. Let's take a preview. Good work! Then we follow the logic of editing for clip 1. We add some changes in the rotation angle for the later parts. After the edits, hit apply to apply the adjustments. Now let's check out these two clips after edits. Alright, that's all for today's tutorial. Be sure to subscribe to our channel to access more easy tutorials about creative effects. Hope you enjoyed it. Bye!